Step one, starting the disc. Here's a disc stationary in between the light source and detector. So what we do is we simply shut the door, and on the software, we choose our set point, the speed that's recommended by the software, and we press start. As soon as we start the disc, there's an interlock which is gone on to the door so that we can't actually open the door whilst the disc is spinning. And this is a safety feature for using the instrument. We should wait till the disc has reached its set point, and then we can start injecting the gradient fluid. We can't use water, because if we try to inject particles in such a fluid, the particles will just fall as a bulk. You get sedimentation instability and streaming effects. What we want is separate bands of particles which don't stick together but separate individually and give us this nice resolution. And for this, we need to have a fluid gradient in the disc. And typically for samples dispersed in water, we use a sucrose water gradient, and we use 8 to 24% sucrose. For this, I'm using a 2 millimeter syringe and needle. Simply take up 1.6 mil of my high concentration sucrose and inject. The next aliquot is taking up 1.4 of my 24% sucrose and adding 0.2 mils of my 8%, giving it a shake in the syringe and then inject into the disc. Next one is 1.2 with 0.4 of the 8%. And inject. So we do this through a series of 9 steps, and that will create our gradient. We're now ready to run a calibration standard. For this, we're going to be using a PVC calibration standard, which has a known size of 0.377 micron and a known density which the software already knows. To run a calibration standard, we simply take up 0.1 of a mil and we place the syringe needle in the injection port. Simultaneously inject the sample and press the space bar at the same time. So we've run the PVC calibration. This should normally take a few seconds to run out. And once that's done, we inject the same volume for the sample. What I've got here is a PVC mixture. I've got some very large particles in here, and we also got some very fine particles in here as well. So we simply take up 0.1 of a mil. We wait for the instructions on the screen, and when it tells us to do so, we simply take up our syringe and needle, place this in the injection port, and inject sample and press the space bar at the same time to run the sample. So we have the sample running out now. The typical sample run time can be anything from a few seconds to a couple of minutes, depending really on the size and density of the material and the disk speed. When the sample has finished running out, you simply terminate the run, and then you can get ready for your next sample. And using this as a procedure, you can run up to 40 samples before the disk would need to be stopped and started up again.